The following video contains spoilers. We suggest watching the episodes alone in the dark. The 2000s Twilight Zone does an episode on baby murder. What can possibly go wrong? Some of you might need a little bit of context first. Just a little. We're back in the infamous G3 era of the Twilight Zone. And this round, we take on another one of the most controversial and divisive tales of the reboot's run. This episode seeks to answer the biggest sci-fi question humanity has had for ages. If you could travel back in time to kill Adolf Hitler when he was a baby, would you do it?
I'm sorry, but I don't want to be an emperor. That's not my business. I don't want to rule or conquer anyone.
Now, in fairness, this is actually a very fascinating concept and has serious potential for great storytelling. World War II was a dark time for the entire globe, nightmare-inducing, and many minds alike have pondered if Hitler never came into power, then could the world have been a better place? Can a better timeline be created? What would happen if Adolf didn't step in? What are the repercussions of altering history? Is it morally justified to execute a child to save billions? These are excellent ideas and huge quandaries which make thrilling epics. However, this concept is being tackled by the 2000s Twilight Zone. You know, the same show which blamed 9/11 on the US government, totally butchered a classic, and had a tale about a perv overcoming his addiction to internet porn. So as you can guess, we're in good hands. Luckily, I have discovered some good episodes from the show as well. So it's clear this reboot does have interesting ideas and fun to share. But whether or not they succeed or fail is the true issue this series always faces. One huge part I enjoy about G3 Twilight Zone is that they at least have the balls to approach darker ideas and insane themes, but they also have a tendency to fumble up their storytelling, fail to be as deep as they pretend to be, or worse, take the dumbest path imaginable. As you all probably figured, this episode is a fine example of why people hate this reboot, since it contains all the worst elements which held this show back from greatness. You know what's sadder than a plot that's bad all the way through? A plot with so much potential to be something grand ending up bad all the way through. The show had complete utter faith in how good this arc was going to be, since it surprisingly tries harder than most other episodes, had a lot of money thrown at it, takes on a dead serious tone, and even has frickin' Katherine Heigl star as our hero.
What?
Yes, award-winning actress Katherine Heigl guest stars on one of the most hated Twilight Zone tales, clearly making a better move than when she was knocked up. While Heigl's of course a good actress, I have no clue why the show even got her to play this protagonist, since she barely gets any personality, is so forgettable you don't even remember her name, and literally could have been played by any unknown actress. Since the hero just acts as an audience surrogate, viewers are supposed to see themselves as, since she gives basic human reactions towards the events unfolding, rather than being a person of their own, like good Twilight Zone protagonists. To put it short, this is a tale where the story arc is the main focus over the main character, and the show wants to explore its amazing complex theme to make us think. Did they succeed? Nope, not at all. Which is why we're here to see what went wrong. This is Cradle of Darkness. So, our episode opens up in the future, where we quickly, and I do mean quickly, get to the time travel mission setup. The episode speeds through a huge info dump super fast, so there isn't much time to know the hero or the future world, which is apparently still feeling the agony of World War II. I'm just saying, time travel is already a super complex story to write, but the show glossing over it does feel like a cop-out. We instantly meet our main character, Andrea, a special time-traveling spy assassin who was specifically chosen by the government to go back in the past to kill a young Hitler before his rise to power. With the aid of her diverse cohorts, they don't give any specifics on why she was the perfect pick precisely, but I believe it's all thanks to her Aryan blood, so she can pass for somebody who can get close enough to Hitler. Again, this actually does have an interesting start, but as usual in modern Twilight Zone, the writers soil the mood by getting very preachy, as they constantly remind you that Hitler was bad, and it's done in a kindergarten way.
And they understand you're never coming back.
I reminded them that Adolf Hitler was responsible for the deaths of 60 million people. Fathers, mothers, children.
I should like to help everyone if possible. Jew, Gentile, black man, white. We all want to help one another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery.
I do like how they establish her time jump is a one-way trip, so she has no redos. But like, is nobody worried that by erasing World War II from ever happening, it'll generate a butterfly effect which could have drastic consequences on time? Maybe even create a worse alternate timeline where life sucks more?
See, that's the thing about time travel, Barry. The more you do it, the less the rules apply to you.
Let's just say this is gonna be one of those time travel plots, which isn't as tight as Back to the Future's level. So she does the time warp in the most silly way the effects team could go with. And she arrives in 1889, during a German-occupied Austria, passing by many wacky characters. So, did nobody see this woman randomly teleport in the center of a busy street?
The more you do it, the less the rules apply to you.
She immediately gets to her mission, where we learn her plan and the big conflict. Andrea is posing as the Hitler family's housekeeper in a small window of time before the real housekeeper visits, so she can assassinate young Hitler. But it's revealed that Adolf is still a baby.
This is the pride and joy of my household. My son. Adolf.
Oh, look at him sleeping. He's like a little angel that killed 50 million people. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
And this is our big conflict for the rest of the episode, and what the show wants us to think on. Is it right to murder a child, one day destined for great evil, if it can possibly lead to a brighter tomorrow? I know there's some fans who adore this concept, and while I do agree this is a phenomenal idea, the show utterly fails to capitalize on it. They make these big promises, but only focus on some of the small potatoes on their plate. For starters, this episode's clearly only tackling the topic of baby murder for shock value. They do a bare minimal job exploring this concept, and make so many mistakes in the writing that it's painfully obvious that they just want to shock the audience rather than challenge them. Despite this episode detailing that Andrea went back in time to kill Hitler, they actually build up to Adolf still being a toddler, clearly to surprise you. And even everyone's least favorite Star Wars character, Saw Gerrera, comes along to hype this up.
What if you had a chance to go back in time and save millions of lives by killing one man? Andrea Collins will soon discover this mission to be more difficult than she ever imagined. as she takes a one-way trip into the Twilight Zone.
Jeez, that green screen still looks awful. I've still yet to find an episode where Forrest looks like he's really there on set instead of his fake teleporting. Say what you will about Serling's narration, but at least he didn't look like a phony effect himself. But I'll admit, in spite of some sketchy digital effects, the best part of this episode is the quality set designs. It's honestly amazing how great the world looks in this, since you truly do feel like you traveled back to an old European village. And it never once feels like this was cheap to film. Most of the G3 episodes often take place at boring locations, or regular areas you'd see in real life, but this episode had so much money thrown at it. Since they do recreate this wonderfully grim realm, you can tell this was an earlier filmed episode because the show hadn't lost that big network budget yet. The series really tries its damnedest to raise the question of whether or not it's moral to kill baby Hitler. A nice topic, but it does take a backseat for a while. No joke, the first half of this episode is a whole bunch of character intros to key players, and depicts Andrea's struggle. There aren't too many characters here, but they are major. We have Hitler's mom, the family maid Christina, and the true villain of the story, Papa Hitler, played by James Remar. You know it's bad when the only other famous person in this is the worst version of Raiden.
It's a new look.
James Remar is actually okay in this. He does decent with what he's given, even giving a more memorable performance than Heigl's nothing of a character. But much like Mark Hamill on The Killing Joke, a great actor can't salvage a sinking ship. In spite of this episode doing a decent job recreating a past era, there's a ton of historical inaccuracies here. The blatant ones surrounding the Hitler fam. The family don't look 100% like Adolf's real parents. Hitler's siblings are omitted entirely. Adolf's an only child now. And Hitler's father is a completely different person than he was in life.
I'm just as surprised as you are.
Ordinarily, creative liberties can get a free pass depending on how well the story plays out, but these small errors do major damage to this episode. It's a tad hard to take a serious drama seriously when huge changes are added to real-life people, and when your changes are only there to justify your biased writing. The greatest problem to me is Papa Hitler. I like Remar, but I can't ignore this. All the episode's problems stem from this dude. This episode's biggest mistake is giving Hitler's dad a complete persona change in order to make him the bad guy. Yes, this episode, which literally has Adolf himself in it and wants to be about the moral ambiguity of child death, inserts a full-blown mustache-twirling bad guy.
Why?
To me, this brings down a lot of the gray morality this plot craves. James Remar's Papa Hitler is nothing like who the real person was, and if that wasn't bad enough, they make him a full-on evil bastard who influences all Adolf's evil instead of keeping the mature, complex theme this episode wants to entertain you with. How is it deep, thought-provoking storytelling if there's a big bad cartoon villain who the episode practically blames as the true reason Hitler turned to the dark side? It's a total spit in the face of history, in vain of Black Anne Boleyn, and insults your intelligence. No joke, Papa Hitler's that old-school, evil, rich white man, a stuck-up snob. He mistreats his own staff, he he's racist, and he's so evil, he even cheats on his wife. Multiple times! This is one of the most cartoonishly fiendish villains I've ever seen since Cobra Commander. Now, I'm aware Hitler Sr. was a bad person, but he didn't flaunt it publicly or be his image. James Remar was a more subtle bad guy when he was Black Mask. They seriously try to do this cat and mouse game where Andrea barely fools the guy to avoid blowing her cover, and Papa Hitler grows suspicious of this stranger coming closer and closer to them. But he's so one-dimensionally evil, and as you'll all soon see, Andrea's a terrible spy. It just cheapens the episode's moral dilemma by giving us a douche to hate when the conflict of slaughtering an infant who is going to grow up evil should be good enough to hold the plot on its own. But nope, we need Dark Raiden to blame for everything. Yeah, don't you just feel the gray morality in the same tale where a rich prick sleeps with another chick while his wife is under the same roof? Really makes you think. While Raiden gives the maid nectar of the gods, Andrea sneaks into the boy's crib, yet fails to notice Mama Hitler in the same room.
What are you doing in my son's room?
Oh, you startled me.
I didn't spot you sitting right next to the door. For a pro spy, Andrea's got bad peripherals. This is Mama Hitler, whose sole purpose is to make the hit job harder, as not only does she hang around the baby room, but Andrea feels guilty over her mission because she sees how much the mom truly loves her tyrannic tyke.
He's so beautiful. So innocent. I must protect him. He is my miracle.
To be fair, this episode could have greatly benefited if we had more moments like this. There's a layer of dramatic tragedy in stuff like this, since the episode hammers it in that Hitler was once an innocent child like everyone else, and had a family who did love him, which makes both Andrea's hit job and his eventual rise to monster all the sadder. I would have respected this tale more if it took a risk by humanizing Hitler and his family just to fuel that hazy morality this episode desires. There's darker material in exploring how Hitler wasn't always a monster. But nope, this episode wants to blame evil psycho daddy and does a bare minimum job at tackling this content.
Never forgets a key. It keeps out the evil spirits.
This magic key is entirely pointless to the whole story, and only comes up one time later for an unrelated reason. It's useless.
Why?
The mom basically acts as an obstacle for Andrea because she forms a sort of friendship with her and shows our hero that Hitler did have loved ones who cared for him, as she shows off her dead children to this total stranger to inform her why Adolf is so special. She lost so many kids that Adolf has become her last love and would just die if anything bad happened. This sincerely could have been a great character and added depth to this uneasy plot, but of course they ruin it by reminding us that Papa Hitler's the real bad guy, since he forbids her from even touching their kid, which he did not do in reality. He cheats on her knowingly, and she's well aware of her man cheating on her frequently, but puts up with it because she's a total simp for Remar's Reich.
My husband is a good man, but he remains a man above all.
She's a simp!
For a brief sec, you almost believe this is going to be morally gray, but evil Papa Hitler brings it all down because he's clearly a guy we're meant to root against. And the mother is proven wrong by her loyalty to him. We waste more time with Papa Hitler than with Andrea pondering a baby murder, and it only makes it so obvious where the plot's going. The next day, he even comes on to Andrea and acts like a snob, just to make us hate him. While Hitler's dad did have numerous affairs and prick qualities, do you really buy he cheated on his wife while in the same house? These scenes could have worked if they weren't handled by CW staff. We also rather awkwardly meet the co-nanny, Christina, which the episode sorta makes a pseudo-foe too, as she's also an obstacle in the way. This chick is the lady Remar is banging on the side, and ultimately, she's also a total simp for that hot Raiden ass. She's afraid of his anger, but oddly finds him hot, and seeks to do anything he asks, because she wants to marry him, most likely for high status.
He says he will marry me someday.
They always say that.
Madame Clara was once the Hitler's housekeeper. He married her when his wife Fanny passed away.
She's a simp!
You're afraid of him. Is that why you let him into your bed?
You heard us.
Yeah. No duh, she heard you. You two are as subtle as Cleveland's sex night.
Ow, 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 ow. When's it gonna be my turn? Ow.
I dislike the simp maid too, because she's merely another black and white baddie to make Andrea's choice easier to choose, since she justifies Papa Hitler's jackassery, openly cheats with him, and is just a dim-witted pawn Andrea plays to her advantage. She's more so a plot device than a real person, so much that Andrea dupes her into going out with Papa Hitler to get them out of the house for the kill. But alas, she cannot do it.
I'm Hitler!
I do enjoy the episode trying to make her struggle with executing a child heavy, since it is a very dark task, where the arc reminds us that even sick, twisted people were once innocent children at one point in time. So the episode does tread carefully with some moments. Even killing a baby destined to become Hitler just feels wrong, because there's no victory in taking away a soul who has yet to grow corrupt.
You're too good for this world.
This is a highly gripping dilemma, because even if it's a horrible person, you're still killing a baby. I truly did want to love this, since I admire ethical debates like this, as the emotion and structure are there. However, the episode always soils on small fires of hope with their garbage writing hose. This concept is botched at every turn, because the show settles on the shock value behind killing an infant, and not the devastating repercussions this will have on history. Andrea is not a deep character because she has zero reaction to the idea of what'll happen if she does off Hitler. Our heroes are going back in time to prevent World War II from ever happening. There's going to be huge time shifts, re-altered events, and even people all throughout the universe will be affected by this. But that never comes up, and the episode's big scare is the dread of killing a baby. The show is more preoccupied with killing off a kid for the sake of drama, rather than the greater scope this kid's death can lead to. Like, she could potentially erase people's existence, or prevent historical events by doing this, but she doesn't seem to care as long as she just stops Hitler and gets over her emotions. I know infant side is serial, but we're ignoring so many effects from this cause. What about the damage to history?
Let's get the hell out of here already! Screw history!
Not to mention, in spite of trying so hard to be this morally ambiguous terror, there is no nuance to any of this writing, since the episode constantly reminds you that a bad guy is behind it all. We have a bad guy in an episode which already stars Hitler. It's not a good mystery or thought-provoking question when the writers are blaming Hitler's evil dada for all the darkness. It takes away from Andrea's more interesting conflict over complimenting it. She even goes to confess to a priest to help give her strength, where he grants us some not-so-subtle foreshadowing.
Give me the strength to do what I have to do.
Only God has the right to take a life.
As per norm, this is a scene which almost works, but gets ruined by more stupidity.
I'm just as surprised as you are.
The bad writing really sabotages a lot of this plot's goodwill. Like, I get it, killing a child is a questionable, huge deal. We're exploring what made Adolf who he is, yet it's just so shallow, one-sided, and unimaginary. This episode has been trying to tease a nature versus nurture theme behind Hitler growing up into the monster we know too well. But this plot fails to explore the multiple other options. If she's so anxious about killing a child like most are, then why not make your job easier? Why doesn't she just poison the baby's food, shoot it in the head, or grant it a merciful death instead of jumping to pain? Why not save him? Why doesn't she try to prevent Hitler from turning evil? Why doesn't she try to be a positive influence to little Hitler's environment? The writers tap on some of these options, but they are barely explored. We get a few stupid scenes of Andrea trying to change time, only to epic fail, where she just gives up and assumes there's no further counter-argument in a tale you should think deeply about. She tries convincing Mama Hitler to ditch her D-bag husband and flee the country with the baby, but she gives no solid reasons why and acts crazy.
Take the baby and go. Leave this house, this country.
But my dear, I cannot leave. This is my home.
Unless you leave here, millions of people are going to die.
What's that? You want me to dump my rich-ass husband, abandon my cushy life, and move to a country we're on bad terms with? Yeah, I think she was nuts too. Did you really think she'd buy that? Here's a stupid question. Why don't you take the kid away and raise it yourself? This episode practically sings how awful the Hitlers are as parents, and it's established you can't time jump back. So why don't you steal the baby to raise it right as your own? Why not try to raise a good Hitler? It doesn't have to be the real mom. You could dump him at a nice orphanage far away. Or hell, since Andrea's stuck here forever, she could start a new life with a new son. I mean, Hitler as your son. That is so Twilight Zone. Why does murder have to happen when you know it's bad parenting at fault? And don't say, oh, well, Kat, that could have harsh consequences on the time stream. Bitch, this entire mission is about erasing World War II from ever happening and altering time. There's no excuse. This chick can literally do anything so long as Hitler never claims his throne. So who cares how or what she does to stop the Reich? She's so desperate to stop Hitler, but has worry over offing a kid, so why not just settle on removing Hitler by whisking him away to a better life than this?
We should take
baby Hitler
and push it somewhere else!
But no, she just gives up after one talk with Mama Hitler and doesn't think up a plan B. So glad this hardened super spy isn't good at improvising. We instantly get another dumb scene where Andrea speaks with Papa Hitler to convince him to change his ways. However, the episode quickly makes him super racist when a gypsy woman annoys him, where he reveals that he prays for an Aryan savior to one day guide his people and purge those undesirables to build a perfect utopia, all just to make us hate him.
Jews, gypsies, vermin everywhere, corrupting our Aryan nation, keeping us from greatness. But one day the people will rise up and clean the streets of such scum. It is inevitable.
Aside from being forced as hell, this scene honestly made me realize why this episode and Papa Hitler suck so much. James Remar is not playing Adolf Hitler's dad. He's playing Adolf Hitler. This character is changed from a working class loser into a prototype of the Hitler we're familiar with. All of Adolf's qualities are given to him to dupe the audience into thinking that this guy passed his ways onto his son. This is dumbed down, lazy, childishly bad writing. The episode saying that Hitler's evil dad was 100% responsible for his son being the big bad guy and molded his whole political worldview. That Hitler wasn't a guy who sought change for his homeland, but a clone of his evil dad. It's taking both Hitler's rise as a powerful dictator and World War II as a whole and simply saying some jackass indirectly caused it all. It's very disrespectful to all the poor lives killed or ruined in one of the worst eras of history by telling folks that Hitler only became evil because he wanted to impress his racist daddy and love him. Like, wow. Way to simplify a dark figure into a guy who had daddy issues and turn the moral riddle into an insult by having a bad guy pulling all the strings. I hate this character because it exposes how unintelligent this drama really is by saying an irredeemable dick caused the worst moments of history rather than all the serious global issues which were taking place at the time influencing Adolf to step up and seize control. The story of Hitler is that he was just a guy who hated his nation falling apart. So he grabbed power in order to make a difference. But over time, it became clear he wasn't Germany's savior, but a bad man shaped by bad ideology. By saying Hitler was evil because his dad's a dark overlord who molded him into the monster of history, it just shows how little these writers know reality, or the issues they're tackling. And no, I can't just see this as dumb, mindless fun because the episode wants us to take it seriously. It's a disgusting trick because they are treating us like children and lying about a real person's life to feed you this blatant bias narrative that's not as smart as it's trying to sound. It's a painfully black and white outlook on what's supposed to be this morally gray story, which wants to make us think. Papa Hitler is just an evil Saturday morning cartoon villain who we're supposed to pin everything bad that happened thanks to Hitler on. He's so vile that his racist rant grants our hero strength to fulfill her job. Here's another question. Why not just kill Papa Hitler? By telling us that this jerk's the true villain of the story, and the man who shapes Adolf's worldview, you also raise the question of why not kill him so he doesn't inspire his son's bigotry? Just kill racist daddy and boom, Hitler won't be motivated to hate minorities and suck as a sidewalk painter for the rest of his life. Plus, you can avoid the discomfort of offing a baboo. Problem solved. But nope, our enlightened time-traveling hero never once thinks to do that. Good lord, our future would have been better off sending Peter Griffin.
Everybody stand back.
Oh boy. Okay.
So, after it becomes clear Papa Hitler's beyond redemption, she's A-okay with offing a child, and knows she has to do it. I mean, what's the alternative?
Push!
That night, the Hitlers host a birthday party for Adolf, with all their elitist pals. All two of them. This gives Andrea the final chance to go for the baby. And rather than offing the boy right then and there, she instead abducts him and runs away, granting the others time to realize he's gone. You know, I just realized, have you noticed that Andrea, an assassin from the future who doesn't want to gruesomely hurt the kid, never brought any weapons with her to give it a quick or merciful death? Yeah, she doesn't like have a gun or poison pills or anything. She always tries to use whatever she can find to murder the infant and doesn't seem to possess any useful tools or equipment to make her job easier. Did the Time Council just send her off with nothing but the old clothes? Why does a time-traveling assassin not have any weapons to help her?
Why can't I get ahead?
You know this writing sucks when minor details like that stick out like a square stash. So, only now do the Hitlers distrust the new housekeeper being alone with their kid, so they send Nanny Simp to watch it, only to discover little Hitler's gone. You know, Andrea, you probably don't need to kill it anymore. You escaped with the baby under nightfall, so why not raise it yourself or leave it at a kind home? The parents never have a clue it's gone, yet you still want to kill it? I guess it's better than the other option.
Push! Push!
Oh, my back!
But Nanny Simp notices Andrea because she drops the spirit key, blowing her cover.
Remember?
Yep, that's seriously the only point of that stupid key, to give away our hero's position. But it just makes Andrea look like a bumbling moron for a spy. Why the hell did she even steal the family's totem in her secret mission?
Stupid?
Nanny Simp pursues her, but she's too late. Andrea commits murder-suicide, ending them both for good. So, was it an insta-kill? She jumps into a river? That's how we kill them off? There's a likely chance both could have survived that. I was kinda expecting something more. I guess it's trying to be ironic since Hitler hates Jews and Jewish babies were drowned in Egypt long ago, but that's...
Stupid?
So, Andrea's mission is complete. The baboo's dead and the nanny melts down. But we get to our twist ending. Terrified of the Hitler fam's wrath, the evil nanny spots the homeless gypsy from earlier, where she buys her kid, bringing it back as a replacement. Revealing, that's right, this kid is the actual Adolf Hitler the whole time. And Andrea killed the wrong kid.
I'm just as surprised as you are.
Yep, this random baby the nanny buys from a homeless gypsy is the real Adolf of Fear, who she brings back to the unsuspecting parents, meaning that time remains the same, and this kid will grow up into our prime Führer. For those of you who don't know, this twist is actually inspired by a popular history theory that Adolf was truly the product of an affair his father had with a gypsy. gypsy lover. A lot of historians suspect that Adolf Hitler was never truly of Aryan heritage, but actually part gypsy, hence why he lacked the Aryan traits he so often paraded as noble. Aryans are usually tall, blonde-haired, blue-eyed, physically fit white folks, yet Hitler seemed to lack some of these stats. Rumor has it that the reason why Hitler despised Jews, gypsies, and other minorities was because he was projecting a ton of his own self-hate onto others, since he saw it as a reminder that he was of no true Aryan blood. Now, I can't confirm how much of that was true, but I do believe Hitler was not a pure breed as he claimed to be. The twist is paying tribute to the then-recent theory that Hitler was a product of an affair, which could have worked, but it's weakened like everything else is due to the god-awful writing. First off, how the heck does Andrea, a time traveler from the future who studied everything about the Hitler clan's tree, not know that Hitler was from an affair with a gypsy woman? She's from a high-tech Coruscant future, yet she never factored in everything or knew this? She's the dumbest time-jumping spy I've ever seen. I declare Andrea one of the stupidest heroes of the Twilight Zone, and I regret nothing.
Why can't I get ahead?
Second, how do the Hitler parents not recognize this gypsy's kid isn't their real boy? There's a brief pause where Papa Hitler might think something's off about his child, but both parents ultimately fall for it and believe this boy is totally their pureblood messiah. Yeah, I truly buy that the mom, who obsessed with her boy to the point of living by his side since birth, wouldn't notice her kid with brown eyes now. And lastly, this twist could have been good if they didn't randomly turn it into a joke. Yes, they crack a joke at this.
Where have you been?
I had to change the baby.
Get it? She changed the baby because it's dead.
It's horrible. How can you even joke about that?
Easily, Doctor. It's not my baby.
A lot of people really love this twist, but I wasn't impressed. The episode just pretends it's deep again. So that's it. After everything, Andrea fails and took the wrong life. The natural order of the universe remains intact. The Hitler fam falls for a blatant lie. Nothing's changed, and Adolf's future is set. Downer ending, Raiden wins.
Sorry. A moment of silence for Andrea Collins. She sacrificed her life for the good of mankind, but she also created the very monster she sought to destroy. History can never be changed, not even in the Twilight Zone.
Ouch.
And that was the end of the most polarizing G3 Twilight Zone tale, Cradle of Darkness. And much like Nazi Germany, it deserves to be blitzkrieged. This is, without a doubt in my mind, one of the worst episodes of the series. It genuinely did have potential to be a fantastic work of art and offer a profound concept through the hit franchise, but it utterly fails to even give us a half-decent story. The Twilight Zone goes through all this trouble, all these dark moments, and slow serial drama, asking us the question, if you would go back in time to kill Hitler as a baby, would you? And what was their answer? It doesn't matter. It ultimately means nothing. Absolutely nothing. Because this episode cops out of giving you an answer and instead gives us this shallow, you can't fight fate resolution, basically saying that you can't change history, no matter how hard you try, even in the Twilight Zone. Like everything else in this story, it could have been great, but the show fumbles it all up with lazy writing and and cheap shock value. They pull a third option out their ass and say history set in stone, leaving no differing thoughts. I could have liked this twist, but the show fails to give a satisfying or solid answer to the question it was raising all throughout this narrative, and only wanted to freak you out with an innocent baby's death. This isn't a story interested in making you think, it's just a cheap thrill that just wants to shock with what's supposed to be a dark story that's not as mature as it believes. The sad part is, I legit think the twist could have worked if the show was willing to go farther with it, or take a different risk other than infanticide. The conflict of killing a child destined for a mayhem is an interesting one, but this clearly lacks faith in the viewer. It wants to act like this is a morally ambiguous sitch and offers dark ideas, but it also has a super black and white good versus evil outlook on things, and makes Hitler's dad the real reason why Adolf turns evil, even with the replacement child twist. There's no nuance in any of this, but the show keeps acting like it's saying something deep when it's not. I can't just view it as Twilight Zone fun because it wants to be edgy. I can't view it as complex because the writing wusses out on the morality scale. And I don't think it's a joy to watch because it's so slow and too dumb at its message. For a tale which seeks to be thought-provoking, it's just too childish by inserting obviously evil characters to make one choice more clear than the other, when they should have detailed the pros and cons of both killing Hitler and not killing him. The show also fails to explore so many other story branches, which could have been more interesting than what we actually got. I know the team's dead set on the dark twist where Andrea fails, and Hitler still comes to power because the universe works in mysterious ways, but why not explore her other options? Push! Like, wouldn't it have been so cool if Andrea did steal Hitler away to raise herself, or if she did assassinate Papa Hitler over the kid? Yet once she thought all was good, Adolf still grew up into the monster we know, as if saying that the people in Hitler's life ultimately weren't responsible for his rise to power, but Adolf was the one who shaped his own future. Nanny Simp is constantly banging Remar, so why not have her get pregnant with the real Hitler? Why not have Andrea try many time jumps to alter history? But no matter what, World War II or some worse events would still occur. Like a new dictator took Adolf's place. Hitler still becomes a monster. War was inevitable between nations even without Der Führer in the pick. Something that still shows how you can't change history no matter how many times you try. That human beings tragically can never play God and alter real life, even with time on their side.
Now that's just science fiction.
Kinda like the female orgasm.
The story we get offers massive promises, and I don't think it delivers on them, because the writers don't really take big risks other than hyping up a baby's death, which could have been good if the story getting there wasn't a mess. The pacing is dull, the characters are all flat or one-dimensional, the debate of right and wrong is bogged down by biased black and white writing, the twist is dumb when you really think about it, the Twilight Zone embarrasses itself by relying too much on shock value, it's historically inaccurate, and worst of all, it refuses to truly delve into abstract sci-fi concepts the show's well known for, because it settles on a poorly thought, below average, edgelord junk as deep as your toilet. This episode sucks, and is everything wrong with this reboot. Its greatest accomplishment is rewarding the G3 show a medal of dishonor. I grant this episode a decayed skull. It is bad. So painfully bad. The only thing saving it from rock bottom is that I do genuinely like the setting and admire how the show tried to make this feel like a classic Twilight Zone experience. But the truth is, like Andrea, this story's a poser. It wants to be the Twilight Zone, but it doesn't get the Twilight Zone. It's a cool idea held back by awful writing, a narrow-minded viewpoint, cheap emotional manipulations, lack of creativity, and dodges harsh messages by hiding behind shocking child death. Cradle of Darkness is an underdeveloped, deformed fail which should have been aborted. Now, I'm going to use this redo device to send a message back in time to past me in order to erase the memory of ever seeing this crap. Do-do-do-do-do. Time to pick out my next review. But what to watch? Cat, what in the Infinity Saga are you? Cat, I'm you. I have to warn you about the future. Whatever you do, Cradle of Darkness. It's Cradle of Darkness. It's next. Ooh, Cradle of Darkness. Bet that's a good one. No! New Cradle of Darkness! It's so fun! Alrighty, I'll do Cradle of Darkness! Oh, this is gonna be so cool! No!
Change the baby.